in this continuation of the previous lab video, we will look at indexing in MATLAB and why it's a very attractive thing for many engineers to work with MATLAB for solving difficult problems, the kind of indexing that MATLAB allows you to do.
So the next thing you need to really understand about MATLAB is how do you index something, right? Let's create a special matrix. This is called the Hilbert matrix. Let's make a smaller version of it and also say, so this is the Hilbert matrix where Aij is 1 by I plus j plus 1, is that right? I plus j minus 1. So this is a useful matrix because if I say it's a very, very small number, the determinant of the matrix becomes vanishingly small. So even though this matrix is not singular, you will struggle to invert it. So this is always a classic example that one classic matrix that somebody looks at when you study linear algebra algorithms. But here the I'm using this as a point to show you indexing. So now if I say A colon, what does this give?
Full matrix. Yeah, A colon
is full matrix. Full
matrix?
Yes. Sure?
Yes.
So what is size of A colon?
4, 4.
Okay. It's going to be 16, 1. So A colon stretches out the matrix. It gives you a column vector of the entire matrix. So in fact, a usual hack that people use is something of this sort. This makes sure that you have a row vector at the end of the operation, right? You take x colon, which will give you a column vector of whatever you have, and then you make it into a row vector by transposing it. Okay, so size of A colon and yeah, so now can you index only this part of the matrix? Can you index the second row? How would you index the second row? So colon is like a wild card. Colon means pick all rows, right? And you also have other nicer things. You can say 2 colon end, you can even say 2 colon end minus 1. Say colon,
there should be a start.
No, you can't, there is no other way to do it.
I think we can start, I
you can say 1. Right, and let's once again look at another simple example. It's not helpful. My font size is too big. Okay. So now we have B. So I can also say, let's just say B equals 1 colon 16 and B equals reshape B comma 4 comma 4. So this is now B. So now what if you want to set every multiple of every third number in the matrix to 0? And what if you want to change all the zeros to minus minus 5?
Find zero and make
This is something known as logical indexing. This is one of the most powerful concepts in MATLAB. This is something you need to understand if you're going to write nice MATLAB code. And the first rule, zeroth rule of MATLAB programming is everything is a matrix. Practically everything that's output in MATLAB is a matrix. Right? So in fact, let's say it's a 1x1 matrix. Right? So everything is a matrix. That is the zeroth rule. The first rule, you should not use loops. Never use loops as far as possible. I'll show you a nice example of a couple of classes down the line when I'll show you incrementally faster codes to compute the Barabasi-Albert graph. There is a graph known as the Barabasi-Albert graph, which we'll cover maybe in the next class. And then I'll show you how you can incrementally write better codes to make the Barabasi-Albert graph. And in fact, for a lot of cases, you will see that instead of writing 10 lines of code with loops and all that, you will end up using like some 3 operations or 3 lines. So MATLAB can be very expressive. Right? So MATLAB is a high level programming language and it is meant to be very expressive. So how do you enter a matrix? You can just use square brackets and keep entering. You can put either semicolon or column breaks or enter to give line breaks, and you can do any kind of submatrix indexing. So let's just say B. So I can say B so this gets me the second, third and fourth rows and the third and fourth columns, right? So this part of the matrix, so 10, 14, 11, minus 5 and minus 5, 16, right? You can do any kind of submatrix indexing in MATLAB. So prod will basically multiply everything that you give it. Size of x will tell you what is the dimensions of x, and you can basically see if what are the number of elements of x. That's the other way to count the number of elements in x.
So in today's video, I hope you had a very nice introduction to how indexing happens in MATLAB, which is probably markedly different from how it happens in many other programming languages. And in the next video, we will look at what MATLAB is famous for: matrices, special kinds of matrices and so on, and how do you write functions and so on.